Hello friends, this is Jimmy from Can Have an Immigration Canada. In this video, I want to update you guys with the latest update from Canadian government. This will explain like who can enter or which workers can enter the country at this moment during the current situation. If we go with the temporary worker exempt from the travel restriction, IRCC, there are two circumstances according to IRCC in which temporary foreign worker from outside of Canada is able to enter the country if they are traveling for non-optional reason. Foreign national who have a valid Canadian work permit or the foreign national who received a letter of introduction from IRCC on a work permit application but whose work permit is yet to be issued. Such individual can give their copy to the air carrier before boarding the plane and they will be allowed to enter Canada. If you are working in the critical occupation and it's on priority basis, IRCC officer will continue to prioritize the work permit for foreign nationals who need or who are looking for entry to Canada to work in optional critical occupation in health, safety and food security and the security reasons. And critically occupation, if we go into the detail about that, they include the provider of emergency services who work to protect the property or like firefighter, medical service worker, or student who are coming to Canada to train in a health field or have received a written approval from the body that regulate that field, marine transportation workers, or the worker who will deliver, maintain or repair medical necessary equipment, or the worker who will enter Canada to make medical deliveries of cell, blood and blood product, tissues, organs or other body parts required to care for the patients. Now let's talk about the scenarios for the non-optional travel who can come to Canada. In example 1, if a foreign national has a valid work permit and currently resides in Canada but he's already out to visit some of the family member, even if the person does not currently have a job in Canada, they can still enter to Canada since Canada is currently their primary residence. Second example, they have given a foreign national who has a letter of introduction, as I mentioned before, for an open work permit, has a valid job offer and will be able to work while and after entering Canada. The third example, they're given a foreign national who has a letter of introduction from a employer-specific work permit or a closed work permit with a valid job offer, which will they be allowed to pursue on entering to Canada. Now let's look at some of the scenarios for optional travel, like you cannot come to Canada. There are two examples the government has provided. Even if you having a letter of introduction for an open work permit, the foreign national want to come to Canada just to find a job, then you won't be allowed to enter Canada. Or after having a letter of introduction from a closed work permit, the employer is currently closed due to COVID-19, even then you will not be allowed to enter Canada. There are some of the discretionary situation where the CBSA officer will make the decision. CBSA officer will consider factors such as foreign national current ties in Canada, whether they'll be working in essential occupation or other motivation for travel to Canada, such as whether an individual will be arriving to Canada to meet their children. So in this case, it'll be all on the discretion of the CBSA officer, whether they will allow you to come to Canada or not. Some of the IEC work permit holder may be able to enter Canada, IEC like the International Experience Class, if the candidate with a letter of introduction and a valid job offer with an employer currently operating may enter Canada. This applies to IEC work permit holder under the three conditions like working holiday, young professional and international co-op work permit. If you are still under this category, you might be allowed if your employer is open for work and their business is running smoothly, then you will be allowed to enter Canada. Another update from IRCC is that the new work permit applications are in process. So if you are having a valid LMIA, approved LMIA, you want to apply for work permit or you want to apply for open work permit, under some other condition that your application is still be taken in and it will be processed within the time frame. So that was a little update from Canadian government about